Okay, so our next performance is by an alumni of ours. He is Elton Almeida. Please give it up for Elton Almeida.
The only thing I was famous for doing in this college was the horrible hosting that I did for Vortex. So yeah, the theme is relationships. And to joke about it, I had to be in one. Which I wasn't, so I can't make jokes on it. Because the joke is already on me. But yeah, you know, I'll talk about something else, which I'm good at. That's sarcasm. I feel sarcasm is taken way too seriously in this country. Like there's probably this, you know, dying man on his deathbed. And he tells his wife, "You'll never find a husband like me again." That's the point. I don't want to get married to someone like you again. I'd rather burn with your dead body. And that's how sati became a trend in India. But you know, like if people feel bad about sarcasm, sometimes, like if people take seriously, then they feel bad also sometimes. And then the good thing about them when they feel bad is you never have to talk to them again. And that's amazing when it's your relatives. So like there's this function that every year our family has, and there's this one annoying old lady who comes and she's like, "Hey, you're that boy, no? Who keeps getting thin all the time. You remember me?" And I'm like, "Yes. You're that auntie who doesn't have Alzheimer's, but still forgets to die." This year she didn't talk to me because this year she's remembered. But sarcasm is cool because my parents understand sarcasm and it's a two-way street with them. I'm horrible at dressing up. And so I always go up to my mom and I'm like, "Hey mom, what do I wear? Wear my wedding gown." That'd be a great idea if I wanted to look like a stripper. "You don't need my gown for that. You always said I had your features." But parents are really amazing, you know. My parents were really amazing. They gave me a lot of things as a child. Permission wasn't one of them. Like, as a child, I heard no more than I heard "I love you." So every time I confessed to a girl and I was like, "Hey, I like you." And she would be like, "Elton, I only see you as a friend." It reminds me of conversations I had with my dad. Like, I'd go up to my dad and be like, "Hey, Dad, I love you." He'd be like, "Elton, I'm sorry. I only see you as a means to fulfill my ambition." The parents are pretty hand in hand. You know, like I'd go up to my mom and be like, "Hey mom, can I go for a birthday party?" "No." "How about a movie?" "No." "Hey dad, can I follow my dreams and ambitions?" "No." So I was joking with my younger brother and I was like, "Hey mom, isn't Elijah adopted?" "No, you are." So parents are pretty much the same thing for me. So I find it really surprising that they get offended when I said no to them. So mom comes up to me and she's like, "So you passed this semester?" "No." "Have you thought about your future?" "No." "Are you a virgin?" "No parent will ever ask you this. They will assume you're one and God forbid if you're not." But my parents were really cool. They corrected me as and when necessary. However necessary. Physically, mentally, emotionally. So, which is why I'm not an asshole today. Like, you see the kids of today, you know? Kids. What assholes. Like, if there was a piece of shit, that would be what children today are. And the biggest shit is their parents. Because these kids have the guts to make noise in a public place. And after making noise, their parents are like, "Oh, my cute demon. Take my phone, take my keys, take uncle's phone, take his kidneys, take his wife. Just keep quiet." But as a child, I never had the guts to make noise in a public place. Because not that I was less of an asshole, but because I didn't want to die. Because my parents were really strict. Like if I did something stupid as a child, my mom would stare at everyone else around. Because if they interfered, they'd also get it. And then she'd stare at me. Now this stare transcended time and space. No matter where I was, what I was doing, I'd stop halfway. Like I was throwing a stone at someone, the stone would stop. I was drinking that second cold drink, then I'd vomit the first one out also. I was breathing, I'd stop breathing. So as a child, I fainted a lot. But then as I grew up, I realized that she's just staring. Stares don't hurt. Let's continue doing whatever we're doing. And then my mom started adapting herself. So she's like, "Come here, Elton." "This is what I teach you at home. This is how I'm supposed to behave." And doing so, she plucked pieces of flesh off my skin. Which is why I'm the poster boy of Ethiopian starvation right now. But then as I grew to get a thick skin, my mom grew to get a heavy hand. And every time I did something stupid, she'd slap the living daylights out of me. Which today I realize is the weight of their expectations coming at the speed at which I disappointed them.